What's up, guys? Corey here. It is December the 30th today. Waiting for New Year's, and usually after the week after New Year's Day is over is when things kind of get back to normal here. So I'm basically kind of just kind of taking jobs as they come in. And I had one this morning that they moved to tomorrow, and then I had another one call and schedule for today in our time slot. Just kind of weird how things like that work out. This is kind of an unorthodox Berber repair. It's a rather small one. It's kind of lengthy, but it's not all that involved. I've shown two or three of these on my above vlog here, and I will show you what I'm getting ready to do here. And this is something that, you know, if you guys run a carpet repair service somewhere, you can probably use this. It's handy to know. Not something I use very often, but let me explain what I'm getting ready to do. This is what's going on here. I harvested some of this out of the closet. I pulled one row out. And what happened here is there's a few places where there's a cat or something had taken this out. If the client hadn't cut this off, I would probably be able to put this right back in its place here. But basically three of these right here in a row. And this is what I'm going to use to fix it with. I'm not going to cut into the carpet. You don't want to cut into a Berber unless you absolutely have to. So the backing is still there. Everything is fine. It's just the fibers that have been removed. So I've got my hot glue gun warming up over there. So here in just a little bit, I'm gonna have the hot glue gun warm enough to start this repair. And basically what I'm going to do is, let's see here, I'm not gonna cut anything until I'm done. Basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a little bead of hot glue in here, pull these guys apart, as far as you can get them apart, put a little bead of hot glue in there, a small one just to start with, and then put this guy in there. Basically at the same time, you know, you're going to be using this, the awl, to tuck it where you need it. All right, then let that hot glue kind of set up a little bit, and then split it open some more, basically with your fingers here, whatever you've got to split it open with, and just move the fibers apart. Holding them apart is sometimes difficult. Basically, you put the hot glue in there, and you have to wait a few minutes when you put it in there. You've got to let it cool just a little bit, or else when you go to stick this in it, it will stick to the awl, and you'll try to pull everything back out of there. And then you get this gooey, nasty mess that you've basically got to start all over with. So it's kind of a trick in waiting until the glue is just right for you to push this guy into it, and then hide the repair. So you can see how it's rather easy to do, but it takes quite a bit of patience to do. So anyway, I'm going to try to explain this as well as I can as I go, and hopefully this will help somebody out there, further their knowledge of carpet repair and their options to do carpet repair on everything that's available to them. But I would never come in. There's another way I could do this, but it's too small. I would never come in and cut the square out and put a new piece in for this repair. The other thing that can be done sometimes, and I generally reserve that for larger repairs, when maybe two or three rows are missing. Basically what you can do is you can cut out the affected area, and then cut one or two rows, whatever length you need, and fit it in there, and then heat it from the top to the tape on the bottom, and fix it like that by replacing those rows, which is a really good way to do it. But this is not a good candidate for that because it's too small. So basically you want to try to fix it, I guess basically you would call it topically, in what I'm fixing to do now. So anyway, I'm gonna shut up here, get everything set up, and the glue gun will be about ready to go by now. and we'll get started with this. All right, I've got this guy as close as I can get to the carpet, basically, and I've got it zoomed in a little bit. So I'm getting ready to, I'm gonna show this in probably basically in real time here. There is another tip, not for this gun that I've seen, but basically a tip that comes out that's a finer point that would work better than what I'm using here now. But basically what I'm gonna do here, I'm going to scoot these guys apart, not for the whole distance, but for at least about half of it. You know, something to be said for, you know, taking a little time with your project here. Basically put not a lot of hot glue, it doesn't need a lot. Basically leave the hot glue in there. Got it where I want it now. So I'm gonna let it set up just a little bit. Hopefully don't get wound up in my own hot glue there. And now letting it cool off just a little bit. Now this is the part that's, you know, you're not gonna, you're basically just feeding this into it very closely and poking it in and down and attempting to hide this. And it always looks better when you're done than when you're doing it. When you're doing it, you're like, I don't know how this is going to turn out. I'm not sure. I have no idea. Pretty much always. But when you're finished, you usually always have, yeah, need to add some more hot glue now. Put a little bit more in right there. All right, so you're wanting to keep basically the softness on the top and the hot glue on the bottom. So now I've got roughly about half of this to go. So let me put some more of that in there. Probably won't see this anywhere else online. I'm thinking. And this one, if there was an extra set of hands, it would work even better. Basically where that is going to stay. Clip that off right there. And we've got a finished repair basically right there. And that's really all I recommend doing to that. If you take the longer way around, you opt to set yourself farther back. This way you've got the problem solved or nobody's going to see it when they walk in the door. And I've got like another one here to make and another one here I'm going to make. I'm not going to cover all that because we've already covered what needed to be done there. So I will, I'll show when I'm completely finished up here. All right, I'm done now.
Well, I don't need to leave me off the anymore. I have to drive 5 hours to come up here.
Oh, really? Where do you live?
McAllen.
Oh, yeah. That's a long ways from here.
Yeah.
I thought it was longer than that. All right, now I'm actually done here, and I've got these guys pointing at the areas that I repaired, which you really can't see, which is what you're looking for in a repair.
Yeah.
So that's good. So basically, you take those off of there, and you come here. Nobody would ever realize you had a repair done.
Yeah, that's good. Looks great. Thank you.
All right, guys, that is today's little, what have I got after this? I've got a couch I've got to go clean. I'm going to go ahead and cover that too, because it's just, you know, work is kind of funky right now. So anyway, that is today's little tiny Berber lesson. And you don't have to be a professional carpet person to do this. If you find this video, you're certainly welcome to try this in your own home. The main thing is to just be careful as to where you get the glue. Basically, just follow the steps that I showed, and you should be able to fix pretty much anything to do with small runs and stuff in Berber. Like there's one in the other room, basically, where the I'm not going to cover it on the video, but basically where a piece is pulled completely out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little dot of hot glue in there and then poke it back down in there and be done with that. You know, I'm not going to charge anything for that. So you can kind of keep your Berber in good repair as you go. And you always want to try to catch it early, because if a dog catches it, they'll take it and they'll run with it. And then you'll have, you know, these rows missing all the way across the room. Anyway, thanks for watching the video, and God bless. And I will see you shortly on the next one.